Hello friends, in this video we are going to study a very important MCQs, the most expected MCQs of the subject International Law in LLM Entrance Exam and UGC NET Law Exam. So these are the most expected MCQs. Let's start with our first MCQ. Our first question is the words international law used for the first time by. The word that is international law was used by the for the first time by which scholar? Our options are Hall, Hobbes, Oppenheim, Jeremy Bentham. So the answer to this question is guys D option, that is Jeremy Bentham. Jeremy Bentham used the word international law for the first time. Our next question is international law is the body of legal rules which applies between the sovereign states and such other entities as have been granted international personalities. Who said that? See, here the definition of international law is given, so we have to tell by which scholar this definition is given. So our options are Whiteman, Schwarzenberger, Holland, none of the above. So the answer to this question is guys B option, that is Schwarzenberger. So he gave this definition of the international law. Our next important question is according to whom international law is really law. So who said that international law is really a law? Our options are Austin, Holland, Oppenheim, Stark. So the answer to this question is Stark, that is D. He said that international law is really law. Next question is who among the following is the father of international law? Our options are Grotius, Austin, Bentham, Pluto. So the answer to this question is A option, that is Grotius. Grotius said that Grotius is the father of the international law. The questions that I am discussing, all these questions are very important guys. Our next question is De jure belli ec pacis, an epic on international law is written by. This is an epic on the international law and it is written by which scholar? Our options are Grotius, Austin, Bentham, none of the above. So the answer to this question is A option, that is Grotius. Our next MCQ is international law is a weak law. International law is a weak law. Who said this statement? Our options are Bentham, Hall, Grotius or Stark. The answer to this question is D option, that is Stark. Our next important question is which of the following is a sanction in international law? So our options are sanction by states, collective sanctions by international organizations, public opinion or all of the above. So the answer to this question is all of the above. So these all are the sanctions by the international law. D is the answer to this question. Our next question is international law is the vanishing point of jurisprudence. Who said that? Our options are Austin, Holland, Oppenheim or Stark. The answer to this question is Holland. He said that international law is the vanishing point of jurisprudence. B is the answer to this question. Our next MCQ is individual is as much a subject of international law as a state. There are certain subjects in the international law. So here it is said that international law is as much a subject of the international law as a state. It was held in which case? Our options are Packet Habana case, the Lawless case, Nicaragua case, Tag versus Rogers. So the answer to this question is B option, that is the Lawless case. In this case it was held that individual is as much a subject of international law as a state. Our next MCQ is in Article 38 subclause 2 of the International Court of Justice the words ex aequo et bono mean. So what does this word means? Our options are considerations of fair dealing and good faith. B option is bona fide behavior by states. C option is relationship of past does not bother present. D option is none of the above. So the answer to this question is guys, the answer to this question means consideration of fair dealing and good faith. Bono means good faith. So the answer to this question is A option. Our next important question is states are bound to fulfill in good faith the obligations assumed by them under treaties. What does this implies? It implies the options are Pact Sunt Servanda, Rebus Sic Stantibus, Ex Aequo et Bono, Opinio Juris et Necessitas. So here we have to tell what does this this statement is, the options under the options, what does this statement is. So the answer to this question is Pacta Sunt Servanda. Pacta Sunt Servanda means states are bound to fulfill in good faith the obligations assumed by them under treaties. Our next important question is a method by which a state may in certain circumstances become a party to a treaty of which it is not signatory is called. So here the statement is given that a method in which a state in certain circumstances become a party to a treaty of which it is not signatory is called what? Our options are accession, ratification, negotiation or none of the above. So the answer to this question is guys accession. A is the answer to this question. Our next question is, so these are certain important questions on the international law. So in our next video, again, we'll discuss some important questions. I'll give you one question. Please answer this question in the comment box, guys. This is also an important question. The question is, states are not bound by treaties unless it is. Our options are signed, ratified, agreed, or none of the above. Please answer this question in the comment box. Thank you for watching the video, guys. Please do subscribe, like, and share the videos. Thank you. Stay tuned.